Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain retarded potential. So, to explain retarded potential, I have considered one conductor. So, this is conductor, and through this conductor, current I is passing. And as current I is passing, for observation point of view, I have considered very small differential volume over here. And because of current I which is passing through this conductor, there is current density J. So current density is J in this conductor. So J is current density. Now, because of charge are flowing in this direction, in this small differential volume, there will be little amount of charge. So volume charge density is rho v. So rho v is volume charge density, which is happening in this small differential volume because of current I is passing. So as current I is passing through this conductor, we are considering small differential volume for observation. Here there is origin. So that source quantity, that is represented by vector r dash with respect to origin, and observation is been getting done at point A. So this point A, that is observation point, where we are dealing with to find potential. So basically there are two different types of potential that happens at this observation point. One is because of magnetic field and one is because of electric field. Now first of all, let us try to understand what happens for magnetic field potential. So as current I that is there in this direction, current I that is there in this direction, magnetic field that is happening as per right hand thumb rule. So magnetic field that will go inside the page as per right hand thumb rule. So ultimately magnetic field that will happen inside the page as per this right hand thumb rule. So magnetic field potential, that will be vector potential. So how to calculate magnetic field potential? So magnetic field potential, that will be vector potential. So let us write vector A, that is magnetic potential. And as magnetic potential is having direction, I need to show it with direction. So that magnetic vector magnetic potential, that will be calculated by mu by 4 pi integration of current density divided by r with respect to volume. So volume integration of j by r. So ultimately vector magnetic potential, that we can calculate by mu divided by 4 pi volume integration of current density divided by r. So that is how vector magnetic potential can be calculated. Now as current is happening in this direction, and as if I say current is positive, electric field that will happen outward from this conductor. So electric field that will happen in this direction at point A. But electric potential is not vector quantity. Electric potential is scalar quantity. So electric potential at this point, that we can calculate by scalar quantity. So we don't need to show arrow over here. So electric potential can be easily calculated by 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 integration of rho v by r with volume integration. So if you do volume integration of rho v, it will be giving you charge. So one can say it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by R. But as I have told, we have a data which is current density in terms of J and volume charge density in terms of rho V. So instead of to write charge over here, we should write down rho V. So over here, as current is flowing in this direction, current density is J, volume charge density is rho V, vector magnetic potential, that will be A, that we can calculate by mu by 4 pi volume integration of J by R. And electric field will be in outward direction. If charge inside of this source quantity is positive, and because of that potential at this point, that will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 volume integration of rho V by R. So that is how we can calculate vector magnetic potential and scalar magnetic potential. But when we talk about time varying field, means here we have AC current which is passing through this conductor. So as if AC current is passing through this conductor, field will be varying with respect to time. Means magnetic field as well as electric field will vary. Like see, for example, if I say current is flowing in this direction, electric field direction, if current is flowing in this direction and if current is positive, electric field direction, that will be this. And as current start to decrease, electric field will decrease. And as if current goes negative, electric field, now that will change like this. And as current decreases, electric field will decrease. So see, this will be happening in case of time varying field with respect to electric field. Now what will happen with magnetic field? So for magnetic field, magnetic field direction, for current in this direction, magnetic field will happen in this direction. And as current decreases, magnetic field value, that will decrease. As per right hand thumb rule, magnetic field depends on current. So as current decreases, magnetic field will decrease. And as if current goes negative, means in this direction, in that case, magnetic field, now that will go in opposite direction. So ultimately, with respect to time, here magnetic field as well as electric field is changing in time varying field. So as if electric field and magnetic field, that changes in time varying field, then we need to have some changes in this two equations. So what are those changes which is required? So let us try to understand that. So in order to use above equation in time varying field, there are few modifications which is required. Now see, thus potential from which the fields are to be derived should be also displayed in finite propagation time. So see, ultimately, as this is getting changed with respect to time, we need to represent this calculation in terms of time. And here vector magnetic potential changes with respect to time as current density changes, and that will change by T minus R by C. The reason is T is time and R by C is even time, but that is what variable time. The reason is over here we keep this observation point at distance R. So ultimately it takes some time to reach magnetic field as well as electric field at this point. So that time will be R divided by velocity of light. So ultimately now we should represent above formula in terms of time. And as we have seen earlier, those formulas were, I am again writing it. So I have already written those formulas. So A is equals to mu by 4 pi integration of J by R with volume integration, and V, that we have written scalar magnetic, scalar electric potential 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 integration of rho v by r with volume integration. But now this formula that will change because of time varying field. So now we should represent this formulas by mu by 4 pi integration, where now j that will change with respect to time. So we should write it by it change with respect to distance as well as with respect to time. So we should write this formula in terms of distance r as well as t by rc divided by r dv. So ultimately this is just a variable parameter which is inside of that j. So j will be function of r as well as time. And over here volume density, that will be even a function of r as well as time. So 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 integration of rho v, that even change with respect to r and time. So time changes by t minus r by c divided by r, and that is what volume integration. So see, this is what changing with respect to time, and one can see this expression that is getting delayed by r by c time. So this expression that is getting delayed by r by c time. So as it is delayed by r by c time, it is retarded by r by c time. This expression is referred as retarded potential. So in above expression, one can see r by c is delay time. So now potential have been delayed or retarded by this amount of time. So for that reason, this potential r called as retarded potential. Thank you so much for watching this video. Now my website link as well as Android application link is available in description, so one can download material as well as they can access all those courses with material with my channel. And for that one can see description where I have placed link of my Android application as well as my website. So you can download it and you can see my website where I have explained all detail regarding my teaching of those subjects, which you can see over here on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching this video.